Halbfinale Nummer 2. Wir dürfen uns noch ein weiteres Mal auf den Weltmeister von 2018 freuen. Den Mann, der in diesem Jahr das World Matchplay in Blackpool gewinnen konnte. Der spielt ein Riesenturnier, hat gerade mal 2 Legs im Turnierverlauf abgegeben. Voltage, Rob Cross! European Tour Turniere hat der Halbfinalgegner von Rob Cross schon in seiner Karriere gewinnen können, stand im WM-Finale 2014, ist der UK Open Champion von 2017. Aus Schottland, Snakebite, Peter Wright!
Gerwyn Price awaits in the final. The Welsh number one and Grand Slam champion is looking to retain his title here at the International Darts Open at the Saxon Arena in Risa. It is either the world number two, Rob Cross, or Peter Snakebite Wright, the world number six, who will go up against the Iceman in the final. Snakebite, the second most successful player in the history of the European Tour, 6 titles to his name. But it's been 2 years since he last won one. That was here in Risa, winning this very title. Rob Cross, despite his brilliance, despite his consistency, despite the world and world match play titles, 7 PDC titles to his name, he has not won a European Tour event. 3 times he's made a final, 3 times he's faced Michael van Gerwen, 3 times he has lost. But with no MVG here, is it finally time for Voltage to take a Euro Tour trophy back to Hastings? It is the World Match Play champion versus the German darts master from the World Series earlier on this year, and a man who was playing some incredible darts at the World Match Play himself.
Rob to throw first. Game on.
Rob Cross and Peter Wright, 1-7 for the right to face Gerwyn Price in the final. Mark Webster alongside me.
Fascinating matchup here. Both players making short work of their quarter-final opponents.
Rob
Cross just dropping the one leg, and Peter Wright whitewashing Adrian Lewis. Set up this encounter.
Well, Rob Cross has been playing better, but Peter Wright hasn't been too shabby. Rob Cross just hasn't been tested yet. That's the thing. He's only dropped 2 legs all weekend. Now, I don't anticipate that trend will continue. He may well win this match, but I'm not sure it'll be an absolute tonking.
No, definitely not. Yeah, close tie. Rob Cross having the better of their recent exchanges this year.
100.
Victory and a draw in the Premier League. And 1 victory on the Euro Tour. Good omen for Peter Wright as well, is that he defeated Rob Cross en route to his UK Open title back in 2017, where he beat Gerwyn Price in the final, who awaits the winner of this match.
Yeah, Rob Cross has this weird habit at the UK Open of only losing to the champion. done it to Michael Van Gerwen a couple of years, done it to Peter Wright, and of course made the final this year, lost out to Nathan Aspinall. If you beat Rob Cross at the UK Open, things are looking up for you.
Yeah, this year's finally openly admitted he just ran out of steam against Nathan.
60.
Didn't have nothing left in that final. Nathan, comfortable winner in the end.
Decent setup shot here from Snakebite. Gives him a very realistic chance of breaking the cross throw.
58.
It could have been better, Roger, but at least he's stayed straight and left himself a makeable Shanghai finish.
Yeah, the combination finishes above the 100. Peter Wright took out 2-1-16 against Adrian 60. Lewis. And this is
a similar route.
On the 116, he stayed on 19s, but he well and truly stayed on the 20s here. Treble for single for tops. And there's the treble.
That'll be the single.
There's the single, and there's the tops in coming for a breaker throw.
80.
Just over the top.
Robbie require 92.
Seemed genuinely confused about how to go about that, Peter Wright. Just shuffling back and forth across the hockey. No confusion here for Rob Cross. Double 16. Double 8 will do.
Rob Cross. Thank you.
Quality finish from Rob Cross.
To throw first.
George Noble there just asking for a bit of order. A bit of whistling going on. And Rob Cross going for the double, but it didn't affect him.
Yeah, they've actually started playing little promotional videos at the start of sessions. The first time I've seen it this weekend on the European Tour, where they're purposefully asking for the crowd to give the best of respect to both players. To be fair to them today, they have been very, very good. There's been very little barracking of Gerwin Price. There's been best of order throughout the day. But if they're going to cheer for anybody and get partisan, you would think it would be this man,
99.
Peter Wright, who is undoubtedly one of the most popular, if not the most popular player in Germany, outside from their own German players.
Yeah, of course, and they waited patiently to see him last night. He was last on, and he was made to work by Richie Edhouse in that encounter. Found himself 3-0 behind before kicking into gear. And Rob Cross, six starts to get rid of 181 for a breaker throw.
Well, it's been just a really solid weekend for Rob Cross so far,
56.
As you would expect for a bloke who's only lost a couple of legs. But the average is over a ton for the tournament. He's hitting 46% of his doubles. And the first nine average is 116. So typically, Rob Cross, every leg, he's on a finish after nine darts. Admittedly, it's a big one.
But
his normal legs this weekend, he's been leaving himself options after nine darts, just as he is here. Treble 20 for tops.
Yeah, he's getting out the blocks, and he's, like you said, Dan, he's giving himself plenty of time at the back end of the leg to finish off. And he's afforded himself plenty of time here. Peter Wright can hope to hit a 1-3-4 across to treble 18. And he does, but it all could be in vain if Rob Cross converts this.
60.
Tops for an early break. And he converts. And that's 20 legs of darts this weekend for Rob Cross. He's taken 18 of them.
Third leg,
drop two.
Throw first. Game on.
And Peter Wright does have some significant victories over Rob Cross. They have met a lot.
60.
Had a big win at the Champions League of Darts, where he went all the way to the final. That was in the group stages. Won that one 10-3. Rob Cross was playing, it was about as close as you can get to his home. Rob Cross down in the south in Sussex. But he just didn't perform at all in that tournament, did he?
No, we were there, Dan. He wasn't at it at all in that tournament. Yeah, but he had the victory over Simon Whitlock, but he marginally got that one and
57.
Went out in the group stage. Courtesy of that defeat to Peter Wright. Peter Peter Wright went on to the final, losing out to Gary Anderson.
60.
It was 2 years ago that Peter Wright won this title. It was a golden year for Peter Wright, 2017. Not only did he win the UK Open, he won 5 European Tour titles. Now, bearing in mind that 5 Euro Tour titles in a year, when there's only Michael van Gerwen, who's won more than Peter Wright. It's only Peter Wright and Michael van Gerwen that have won more than 5 in total.
Exceptional form right here, and I seem to recall in single finger he defeated Michael van Gerwen 6-0 one of the Euro Tour finals that year. So everything he touched on the Euro Tour basically turned into gold that year.
60. Robbie Lacroix, 104.
Should have won the Premier League that year as well. It really was incredible from Snake Bites. But this would be 3-0 for Rob Cross. Double 16 is the target. Oh, and he's just pulled it 86. Into the double 7.
Peter Wright, 141.
Peter Wright might need something special to get himself going in this game.
's the first part of the equation, treble 19, just too high, so Rob Cross returns for double 9.
89.
It's a double you'll be familiar with because he likes double 18, so he'll be used to switching over.
Games on the third. There's
a three legs on the spin for Rob Cross.
Well, it is first to 7, so there is a little bit of extra time for Peter to turn this round, and of course he did have to come from this sort of position in his opening game against Richie Edhouse. But to come from this position against the world number 2 is tough, but it's not impossible.
It's a better start than any. Maximum start. Peter Wright attempting to get his first leg on the board.
100.
Rubbish, says Rob Cross. Not happy with that after the first dart. Felt he should have been coming away with at least a ton 40.
Rob Cross averaging 7 points below his tournament average at the minute, but it's proving more than enough so far. Confirmation, Peter Wright actually averaging 5 points more, but finds himself 3-0 behind.
Yeah, he's only 99. Had one dart at a double, though, Snake Bite, in this game so far. His chances have been limited. He should get chances in this leg. Should get quite a few.
100.
Yeah, plenty of time. Rob Cross should be starting on the 18s. So Peter Wright has still lost 6 starts, getting to 81. Register his first leg of this semi-final.
Double 12 it is then. Some way off.
69.
Gonna miss darts at a double do when your opponent's on 207, but eager to get this first leg on the board. Still not under massive pressure.
Game shot converts. Peter Wright.
First leg for Peter Wright.
Fifth leg.
To close the gap.
To throw first. Game on.
It's Rob Cross who's got that early break. Without playing like he has throughout the rest of the tournament.
140.
But Rob Cross is a good front runner. He's hard to chase down once he gets out in front.
His snake bite lifting his game. Kicking off the last couple of legs with maximums 14 for Peter Wright. Twice the number of Rob Cross, although he has played a lot more legs.
83.
But he is hitting 180s more regularly than anybody on the planet this year.
80. Mentioned in the previous match with Adrian Lewis, Peter Wright using a different set of darts again. He's not
26.
Overly happy with the weight of the darts. He says he'd rather them throw with a lighter set, and he will be altering that after this tournament. And like Peter Wright, mess around with his darts, really.
98.
I remember him going up on stage at the match play last year with a darts case with seven different sets in. He genuinely wasn't sure which set he was going to use until he actually started the match.
He once contemplated, I'm sure he mentioned, about having a different set of darts to finish the leg in, which is...
Well, there was a spell where he was finding he was scoring 100. Brilliantly with these thinner, lighter darts. You can get them in the treble 20 more easily, but his finishing was great with a sort of big, bulbous Phil Taylor-type dart. And there's nothing to stop you from using different darts. And Peter Wright, if anybody in the world can adjust his throw to deal with different darts, it's Peter Wright. He does it all the time.
I'll support Peter Wright with his darts tweaking, as long as we don't see those wobbly points. Not the fan of them, and after the way Peter played them in the Premier League this year, I'm sure we won't see them again.
I wouldn't rule it out.
60.
Wow.
Peter Wright.
Nowhere near the double top there. Peter Wright gets another look at a 1-4-1. He wasn't able to give himself a dart at it at the double in leg three. And the same thing has happened.
89. Robbie McGuire, 20.
To consolidate that early break again. Let's open up the gap to three. Rob Cross. Up to double five. A little pause and stares the double down 15. And slips inside. And a first mistake of the match for Rob Peter Cross.
McGuire.
Gives Peter Wright a chance 52. To get back on throw.
Peter Wright does not miss double 10.
Peter Wright
gets the break back. The German crowd roar their approval.
Sickler Peter to throw first. Game on.
Rob Cross missing doubles and will be slightly concerned. He's not playing as he has in previous matches. 10 points now below his tournament average coming into this match, which was just above 101, but Peter Wright ramping up the pressure on Rob Cross. And Rob Cross hasn't been under any sort of pressure throughout this tournament.
Well, this is it. 16. He hasn't been tested, Rob Cross, and Peter Wright is starting to really test him because each of the last three legs he's kicked off with a 180. He may as well start from 3-2-1. And could he leave 1-4-1 again for the third time in the match?
140. Oh.
There was a big pause there as everybody in the Saxon Arena wasn't quite sure whether the nine darter was
140.
On.
He was just out of shot, but you could just see on the expression Peter Wright, he knew he just overpitched it over the top, but on your throw, if you're on 181 after six darts, a very convincing position.
Nicely rescued with that last dart, leaves him on a nice little two darter.
134, Peter Wright, 89.
Treble 19 for double 16 for an 11 dart leg and a level game. Well, now where's he looking? Does he go 20 and bull? I'm not sure he is. Cheeky.
49.
And potentially a mistake.
167.
Yeah, will it be worth the risk? Rob Cross, not on his fluent self in this match. You won't be expecting this to go, and it's not going to, so good gamble from Peter Wright, but he has to convert.
127. Peter require 40.
Sets up the shot very well, Rob Cross, but that might not matter. Double 10 again. Double 10 is pinned again.
Peter Wright. So they were off to throw first. Game on.
Well, Rob Cross, 3-0 up, seemingly cruising. Peter Wright,
81.
Not really at the races, and he has raised things. Could he kick off 180 for a fourth consecutive leg? Not this time.
45.
just his general demeanour this weekend, Peter Wright, seems very, very relaxed. He's, even when he's been put under pressure, he seems, he's not quite as intense as he can be. Sometimes he looks like he's really grafting, really trying, but this weekend he's just seemed quite happy to go along with the game and expects that things will get better. He just seems, maybe it's confidence, just playing with a carefree attitude.
140.
Yeah, I'd echo that, and it epitomised that in the opening round. He's Richie Edhouse, who's 3-0 down, but there never seemed any sort of alarm bells ringing, and he's worked his way into the match. And he's Mensah Sulevic as well. He found himself in a little pickle there, and especially against a play, hasn't been beaten on a regular basis, but he got the job done. So the relaxed approach has been working for Peter Wright this weekend.
Yeah, it's not been his best stuff 100. By any means, but it has been good enough to win games. Is it going to be good enough to book his place in the final? It would be
140.
A second Euro Tour final of the year. Did make the final in Sindelfingen and very nearly beat Ian White, but was unable to take his chance in the last leg decider.
Thing to recall Peter Wright being in a 65. Position of control to win the match 8-6, and he let that slip through his fingers, and Ian White closed the match out.
Don't think that's a help.
11.
And that is a major hindrance for Rob Cross.
Did you require 151?
Still expect to return. Knowing that it's only going to be two darts at the double, if he does return, in fact, treble 17, leave the top of the shot, but disappointing that.
Keeps threatening these big combination finishes, Peter Wright, getting the first treble, but is unable to get the second.
Robbie Wire, 17.
On for double eight for Rob Cross.
Go back into the lead.
He's on the more like it. Rob Cross.
Just giving himself a little talking to Rob Cross. Not a situation he's found himself in this weekend, where he's lost more than one leg.
Obviously, Rob Cross satisfied to be in the lead, but you can tell a little talking to him there. He's not overly thrilled with the way he's playing. He knows that he gifted Peter Wright the breaker throw back with a missed dart at double 10 and double 5.
98.
He does have the darts, so his advantage Cross.
$140.
Presumably Gerwyn Price will be back in the practice room right now, hoping that these two knock seven bells out of each other and it kind of depletes their reserves of energy and focus for the final.
57.
Yeah, I always think it's a better position to be in that first semi-final. Get yourself back, just get yourself freshened up.
$105.
Peter Wright does navigate his way through this match, we will be guaranteed a second title in Risa for one player. Gerwyn Price, Peter Wright, both previous winners on this stage.
PG require 116.
This tournament does have a history of throwing up first time winners on the Euro Tour, though. As Wright looks at tops. And pins it to level this game once more with a 12 darter and a ton plus checkout.
Game on.
Yeah, Michael Smith, a first time winner when he won the inaugural one. Mensah Sulevic's first Euro Tour title when he won in 2016. And Gerwyn Price, of course, became a Euro Tour champion for the first time here last year. By contrast, this title 2 years ago was Peter Wright's sixth and most recent Euro Tour title. It's been a long while between drinks for a man who at one stage was expecting to pick up a title every month when he was turning up on the European circuit.
99.
He'll be disappointed by his standards that he's only reached the final on one occasion on the Euro Tour this year, but he did have that double header win in Barnsley when he went both Pro Tours and when I won the World Series German Darts Masters.
Yeah, so he does have a victory in Germany this year. 16. That was in Cologne.
defeating Gabriel Clemens in the final. We're expecting big things from him in the future.
Big things from Rob Cross right now. 180 number two.
Robbie McGuire, 101.
Time on his side. Look at the bullseye.
Oh dear.
28. Oh,
where's that come from as a visit? Long way wide, and he may only get one dart at a double when he returns. And Peter Wright could be breathing down his neck. And is doing so. He's just taken out 116. 110 will hold no fears for him. That's a great dart, though.
Yeah, can he tidy up after a poor setup shot? Two at double eight. And he needs the both of them. And 57. There's the error. So chance for Peter Wright to move in front for the first time in this semi-final.
And it is a couple of misses from Rob Cross, but he should have had more darts for this leg. And he may not get any more darts for this leg, because double 16 for Peter Wright means that he goes into the lead.
Quality finishing from Peter Wright, and the careless setup shot from Rob Cross affording Peter Wright the chance, and he converts and hits the front for the first time in this semi-final.
Well, now we'll see what Rob Cross is made of here this weekend. His first three games were absolute cruises.
57.
101 average all the way through. Only lost two legs in three matches. He's been allowed to stroll through to the semi-finals. And now he's being tested.
93.
And he'll have to come from behind.
60. To switch there. Didn't look like there was a lot of room.
Yeah, well, if you're going to pick three players in the world of darts who are so stubborn on the treble 20, even when it's to their detriment, Peter Wright, Max Hopp, and probably James Wade would be the three you'd go for.
I'll give Wade his credit, though. He is one of the best at moving along the hockey and finding that treble when it's blocked.
I bet. They're absolutely spectacular at it, but they get a lot of practice.
Yeah. 134.
Can hit the treble 19, as he's just shown.
40.
Another loose dart from Rob Cross.
40.
Oh, what is it? Is it fatigue? Is it just... I mean, we know he can play at 101 average all day long. He's been playing 100 average all year long, Rob Cross.
60.
But once again, he's looking like the best player in the tournament, and then it gets to the latter stages, and something just goes wrong. And this might be going wrong for Rob Cross. And what looked like a golden opportunity to pick up a first Euro Tour title is not quite as golden right now, but a golden visit will get him an opportunity.
Yeah, perfect timing from Rob Cross. Just as his throw has been broken, he's carved out an opportunity for himself.
Two darts. Robbie McGuire, 48.
Likely to be at double 16. To level us up. 1-1 on the doubles. It isn't. A good last dart from Rob Cross. Still doesn't look overly thrilled up there. And despite a bit of shouting out while he was throwing,
to throw first.
Compose himself game to convert. On. And he has the darts. And we are again at a position of best of three scenario.
140.
Can he make a late dash for the line?
Peter will be disappointed though in that leg. He hit the 110 60. To moving front for the first time, and his first six darts of that leg, the 10th leg, but without a treble. Rob Cross broke back with relative ease in the end.
100.
Well, Cross's best stuff this weekend has come when he's been allowed to get in front and just power away from people. Peter Wright, by contrast, when he's been tested, he's played his best stuff. Richie Edhouse brought out some fabulous stuff, Peter Wright, in his opening game. Mensur Suljovic saw Wright take the game away from him. In adversity, snakebite has blossomed, 100. But maybe this is just a bridge too far.
Rob Cross has regrouped really well. Some doubles early in the game and that poor setup shot from 101 when he left 73 and couldn't convert. But he's in control of this 11th leg and it sensible dart. He just sets up the shot.
129.
And Rob Cross will have three at double 16 to go one away from a place in the final against Gedwin Price.
30. Review required.
No pressure at all. And Rob Cross, when there's no pressure on, should be able to tidy this up. Very simply.
Rob Cross.
One away from making a Euro Tour final once again. And just for a change. In fact, for the very first time, Rob Cross could find himself in a Euro Tour final. And it is not the best player on the planet, Michael van Gerwen, who awaits.
100.
It is still one of the best players on the planet in Gerwin Price, the defending champion. But it might finally be happening for Voltage on the Euro
96.
Tour.
96.
Whoever gets through, it's a tough task. Gerwin Price will be wanting to go one better. He got to a final in the midweek in Barnsley. Losing out to the Portuguese star Jose de Souza and just didn't really turn up in the final, so he'll want to put that right tonight.
Yeah, probably the worst game he's played in quite some time, Gerwin Price. He's taken his frustrations out on his opponents this weekend, though.
58.
Gerwin Price has been tested in all the rounds he's played. Kyle Anderson pushed him all the way. Nathan Aspinall. Joe Mernon 60. Pushed him this afternoon, but Gerwin Price pulled away. And we saw victory over Glenn Durrant in our first semi. It's sealed Gezi's spot in tonight's final.
100.
Well, we have seen these two draw a couple of times in the Premier League.
100.
6-6 earlier on this year, 6-6 last year in Rob Cross's debut season in the tournament. We've never seen them go down to a last leg decider in a must-win game, though. One where the draw is not
if
an option.
101.
It's looking all the more likely we're going to see that for the first time. Peter Wright looks at treble 19. And double 12 for another 10-plus finish.
89.
Just short.
Robbie Require 170.
To avoid a last leg decider, Rob Cross is looking at the biggest checkout in the game. But it is just too big.
61. PT Require 12.
To take us all the way.
Awkward coming down the board for double three. And Rob Cross,
no score.
Regretting that visit of only 61 on the previous visit. But only one treble needed in the combination. Treble 19 for double 16. Not to be.
43.
Six starts from 170. Rob Cross does not get himself a match dart.
12.
Peter Wright let off there. Sliding in alongside that one, just like that, and the crowd's roar tells you that their favourite man, Peter Snakebite Wright,
game on,
is still in with a chance of winning this title again. One leg to decide it, the world number two and the world number six.
140.
Peter Wright's broken Rob Cross's throw twice in this match, and if he's going to take his place in tonight's final, he's going to have to do it again. And a good start to the leg. World number two. So Rob Cross has a lead of 80 plus these.
Very little between them. Another treble.
140.
Another treble would have meant there's literally nothing between them in this leg, but 40 points could prove to be vital.
40.
A slip from Rob Cross. Rob Cross has just got to tell himself, get rid of this in six darts. He's up to the 18s now.
57.
Two poor visits without the treble for Rob Cross. Yes, it's a finish, but it's a big, big ask. And Peter Wright can leave himself really handy here and on the verge of a place in the final.
45.
Well, both massive Romeo finishers. Rob Cross would need the bullseye. Peter Wright wouldn't. Cross is not going to get a match dart in this visit.
96.
He chips away.
Peter, you require 160.
For a sensational come from behind victory against the world number two. Oh, I just didn't have enough.
100.
This is no gimme for Rob Cross under
68.
In these circumstances. Treble 20 for double four will be the route. 16 for the double.
That hand is shaking a bit. Can he hold it together? Can he hold his throw? Can he hold on to his hopes of winning a first Euro Tour title tonight? He can! Rob Cross, after cruising through the opening rounds, has to really dig deep and battle past Peter Snakebite Wright. But one dart into double 16 has booked his place in the final here in Risa. We have our finalists, Gerwin Price, the Grand Slam champion, and Rob Cross, the World Match Play champion, go head-to-head at the Saxon Arena in front of a couple of thousand German fans. It'll be about 20 minutes from now that the final gets underway. Price looking to retain the title. Rob Cross looking for his very first on the European Tour.
Rob Cross steht zum ersten Mal im Finale der International Darts Open und trifft dort auf Gerwin Price. Großen Applaus für Snakebite Peter Wright, hat ein tolles Turnier gespielt.